Hi, I'm John, and welcome to part two in this IT Taster video series covering IP version 4 addressing. In part one, we examined what an IP address is, we did a little bit of binary and talked about dotted decimal notation, and we also examined the structure of an IP address. In this video, I'm going to cover subnet masks and how they work, and also some useful techniques that we can apply. If you've worked with network devices before, you'll have encountered a subnet mask like this. The subnet mask 255.255.255.0 is written in dotted decimal notation. The subnet mask has an important function. It defines which part of the IP address is the network ID and which part is the host ID. In order to understand how a subnet mask works, and also when performing more advanced techniques involving subnet masks, it's essential to be able to work in binary. If your binary is a little rusty, why not take a look at the Introduction to Binary video featuring the Raspberry Pi, which can be found on the IT Taster channel. A subnet mask, like an IP address, is made up of 32 bits. And if we convert the subnet mask in the example to binary form, it looks like this. If we take a closer look at the subnet mask, we can see it consists of four octets, just like an IP address. But the subnet mask works in a very different way to an IP address. A subnet mask is said to be contiguous. That is, reading from left to right, bits set to 1 are followed by bits set to 0. Unlike an IP address, a subnet mask is not made up of ones and zeros mixed together. Subnet masks follow a simple set pattern of ones followed by zeros. Each bit in a subnet mask can be set to on with a 1 or set to off with a 0. Bits that are set to 1 mean network. Bits that are set to 0 mean host and network device. And this is how the subnet mask is configured to specify the network portion and the host portion of an IP address. All of the bits set to 1 determine the network portion, and all of the bits set to 0 determine the host portion. It's extremely important to be able to work in binary because we can easily see how the subnet mask determines the network ID and the host ID when applied to an IP address. We're able to establish the network ID, which is 192.168.0, and the host ID, the individual device, which is 4. When we configure a network device, we must ensure the correct subnet mask is used. The device must belong to the correct IP network, and the device must be assigned a unique ID. In this example, we have two PCs. Both have the same subnet mask, 255.255.255.0. And if we examine both IP addresses, we can see the network ID is the same, 192.168.0. Both devices belong to the same IP network. However, each device has a different host ID, because each host must be unique. Both devices are correctly configured, and therefore able to communicate. In this next example, we have two PCs again. They have the same subnet mask, 255.255.255.0. But if we examine the IP addresses of the two PCs more closely, we can see the network IDs are different. The network ID of the PC at the top is 192.168.0, and the network ID of the PC at the bottom is 192.168.1. The host IDs for each PC are unique, as they should be, but because the PCs have different network IDs, they don't belong to the same IP network, and therefore they're unable to communicate. Now, there are two very important things to be aware of when assigning an IP address to a network device. The first thing to be aware of is all of the host bits cannot be set to zero. This isn't a valid IP address that can be assigned to a network device. When all of the host bits are set to zero, they're used to identify the network, and this is known as the network address. In this example, the network address is 192.168.0.0, and this is something routers will use to determine where to route network traffic. The second thing to be aware of is all of the host bits cannot be set to 1 either. Again, this isn't a valid IP address that can be assigned to a network device. When all of the host bits are set to 1, this is known as the broadcast address. The broadcast address is used to send network packets to every device on the network, all nodes. Knowing how to work in binary is so useful, because we can use binary to determine the network address a host belongs to. To do this, we need to apply a logical AND calculation to the host's IP address and subnet mask. As a quick refresher, here's an AND gate, so let's quickly go through it. The rules are very simple. Inputs A and B determine the output C. So if we input 0 and 0, this outputs 0. 0 and 1, output 0. 1 and 0, output 0. And 1 and 1, outputs 1. OK, let's now apply this to the host IP address and subnet mask in the example. Let's begin with the first octet. 1 and 1 is 1. 1 and 1 is 1. 0 and 1 is 0. And that's the same for the remaining bits. And this gives us a value of 192 for the first octet. For the second octet, 1 and 1 is 1. 0 and 1 is 0. 1 and 1 is 1, 0 and 1 is 0, 1 and 1 is 1, 0 and 1 is 0, and that's the same for the remaining bits. And this gives us a value of 168 for the second octet. For the third octet, 0 and 1 is 0, and that's the same for the remaining bits. And this gives us a value of 0 for the third octet. And finally, the fourth octet. 0 and 0 is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1 and 0 is 0, 0 and 0 is 0, and 0 and 0 is 0. And that gives us a value of 0 for the fourth octet. And we arrive at the network address of 192.168.0.0. Binary also enables us to determine the number of usable host addresses. To calculate the number of usable host addresses, we raise 2 to the power of the number of host bits. In this example, the subnet mask 255.255.255.0 gives us 8 host bits. So we need to raise 2 to the power of 8, which is 256. But remember, we cannot assign an IP address to a device if the host ID is all zeros, or if the host ID is all ones, because a host ID of all zeros is used to identify the network address, and a host ID of all ones is the broadcast address. So we must remember to subtract 2 from the answer, which equals 254. 254 is the number of usable IP addresses we can assign to our host devices. I've talked about the importance of being able to work in binary, but when it comes to configuring devices, entering IP addresses and subnet masks in binary isn't practical. You're already familiar with a subnet mask written in dotted decimal notation, as shown in this example. But it's also important to be aware this isn't the only way a subnet mask can be expressed. If we take our example IP address of 192.168.0.4 and subnet mask of 255.255.255.0, the IP address can also be written as 192.168.0.4/24. This method is known as slash notation, and it enables us to abbreviate the subnet mask. instead of writing 255.255.255.0, we're able to simply refer to the subnet mask by the number of bits set to 1. And in this example, the number of bits set to 1 is 24. The three most common subnet masks you'll encounter are these. And they are the default subnet masks for the three most commonly used IP address classes. And we'll take a look at IP address classes and important addresses to be aware of in the next video. It's important to be aware that subnet masks don't always appear in the form of the three default subnet masks shown in the previous example. IT professionals need to be able to divide an IP address space into smaller pieces, known as subnets. This is something internet service providers do frequently. IP addresses are in short supply, so customers are only given the IP addresses they need. It's also commonplace for organizations to divide an IP address space into smaller subnets for efficiency, or if the organization spans different geographical locations. Now, if we examine the subnet mask 255.255.255.0, we can increase the network ID and reduce the host ID by setting more bits to 1. The subnet mask now reads 255.255.255.192. We've borrowed 2 host bits, given us less hosts, but we've gained more networks. Borrowing host bits in this manner is known as subnetting. And we'll take a closer look at subnetting later in the series. Well, that brings us to the end of the video, and I hope you found it helpful. In the next video in the series, we're going to take a look at IP address classes. We're going to cover public and private IP addresses, and also some other important IP addresses to be aware of. Don't forget, please subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. Your comments are welcome, and thanks for watching.